কি হয়েছে? গুড মর্নিং স্টুডেন্টস,
গুড মর্নিং ম্যাম।
রোল নাম্বার ওয়ান,
ইয়েস ম্যাম।
কুনাল, রোল নাম্বার ওয়ান
ইয়েস ম্যাম।
অ্যাবসেন্ট?
ইয়েস ম্যাম।
ইউ আর হিয়ার, দেন ওয়াই নট গিভিং ইয়োর অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স? রোল নাম্বার টু,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
থ্রি, রোল নাম্বার থ্রি, রোল নাম্বার থ্রি প্রেজেন্ট, ওকে। রোল নাম্বার ফোর,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
ফাইভ,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
সিক্স,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
রোল নাম্বার সিক্স,
রোল নাম্বার সিক্স প্রেজেন্ট।
সেভেন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
রোল নাম্বার সিক্স প্রেজেন্ট, ওকে। রোল নাম্বার সেভেন, সেভেন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
রোল নাম্বার সেভেন, এইট,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
রোল নাম্বার এইট, নাইন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
ইলেভেন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
টুয়েলভ,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
থার্টিন, রোল নাম্বার থার্টিন, রোল নাম্বার থার্টিন অ্যাবসেন্ট, রোল নাম্বার থার্টিন প্রেজেন্ট। ফোরটিন, রোল নাম্বার ফোরটিন, ফোরটিন ইজ অলসো প্রেজেন্ট। ফিফটিন
ম্যাম,
সিক্সটিন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
সেভেন্টিন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
এইটিন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
বাই,
নাইনটিন,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
টোয়েন্টি,
প্রেজেন্ট ম্যাম।
টোয়েন্টি ওয়ান, Roll number 21. Absent. Twenty-two present. Joy Chakraborty. 23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28.
Present, ma'am.
29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33.
Present, ma'am.
34.
Present, ma'am.
35.
Present, ma'am.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Yes, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40.
Present, ma'am.
41.
Yes, ma'am.
42.
Yes, ma'am.
43.
Present, ma'am.
44.
Yes, ma'am.
45. Roll number 45. Present. Okay. So today, one student is absent and of roll number 21. 21 is absent for today. 21 is absent for today. Sharing screen is visible. Just wait. Sharing screen is visible or not?
Visible, ma'am.
So these things I discussed last day. Origin of quantum theory, black body, its definition, its example, characteristics of black body radiation, Planck's hypothesis and radiation law, and energy distribution, average energy, Planck's law, derivation of Planck's law. I derived the expression of U nu d nu and also U lambda d lambda. Nu is the frequency, energy density in terms of frequency, and energy density in terms of wavelength. These things were discussed last day. Now, I told you that if you can read these topics, that is counting modes, otherwise no need to go in detail. This portion, mode number, it is given in the note, but only so remember, up to this portion, it is very important. Planck's law. So this is the Planck's radiation law, U lambda d lambda equal to this, up to this I derive. Now with the help of Planck's radiation law, we can derive Wien's law, Wien's displacement law and Rayleigh-Jeans law. Now I'm coming to the next PPT. So it is directly written here, what is the Planck's law? And now I'm going to discuss Planck's law with approximation. So approximation I am taking. So the denominator term, what is in the denominator? Tell me, e to the power? H nu by KBT. Now I'm breaking this, e to the power H nu by KBT. Now mathematically we can write 1 plus H nu by KBT plus H nu by KBT whole square in this way. And this minus 1 is written here. So this is the approximation. So discussing the Planck's law with approximation, I have taken nu equal to c by lambda. You all know that. Now u lambda, u nu d nu equal to what? 8 pi h nu cube by c cube. Then d nu is here, and e to the power h nu by KBT. This term I am breaking. This term. So this term is 1 plus h nu by 1 plus h nu by KBT plus this whole square plus in this way. It will go on, and with that minus sign. Now h nu by KBT. It is very, very less than 1. Low energy approximation. So it is very, very less than 1. Then what I will write? So what will be the square term if h nu by KBT is very, very less than 1? So what we can write? If we increase the power of h nu by KBT, then say, anyone say, then why I will not consider the higher terms? Can I consider the higher terms or I will not consider the higher terms if h nu by KBT is very, very small?
No, not consider the higher terms.
Because this has a negligible contribution with respect to this term. So if I square it, the value is very, very less. So as h nu by KBT is very, very less than 1, so I will not consider the higher terms because the value is less, very, very less. So approximately, this is the approximation sign. So approximately, we can write it 8 pi h nu cube by c cube d nu by. So this plus 1 and minus 1, these two cancels here. So what remains? H nu by KBT. This only remains. So see here, H nu by KBT. This only remains. So this is U nu D nu. The approximation is what? 8 pi H nu cube by C cube D nu by H nu by KBT. In terms of, it is written in terms of frequency. Now same thing if we can write in terms of wavelength. Now you know the relation, frequency equal to C by wavelength. So I have written this one. So u nu d nu, that is u lambda d lambda converted here. So that is equal to, if you put the values, then d nu you will again you will get d lambda here. So if you put all the values, you will get 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 KBT d lambda. So u lambda d lambda equal to this. So this is the low energy approximation when the value of h nu by KBT is very, very small. Then the Planck's law with approximation part, it is reduced to this one. So it is reduced to what? Planck's law. Now we can write it as 8 pi h nu cube by c cube d nu by h nu by KBT. This is u nu d nu. And if I write u lambda d lambda, then I can write it as 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 KBT d lambda. So this is the approximation case. Now, according to Rayleigh-Jeans law, the energy density of the black body radiation between lambda to lambda plus d lambda at temperature T. What is this? This is u lambda d lambda equal to 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 KBT d lambda. So from here, 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 KBT d lambda. So what is this? This is u lambda d lambda. So this is u lambda d lambda equal to this just I have derived with the approximation of Planck's law. And what is the approximation of Planck's law? This is u lambda. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, U lambda d lambda, this expression you have to remember. What is this? 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 kbt d lambda. And from where I am getting? From the expression of u nu d nu with the approximation. Now, ultraviolet catastrophe or Jeans paradox, that I am going to discuss. According to the Rayleigh-Jeans law, the energy density of the blackbody radiation between wavelength lambda to lambda plus d lambda at temperature T equal to this. Just I have proved this one. Just. Now, this is the expression. So, this can be written according to the Rayleigh-Jeans law. Now, the energy density U lambda, if it is tends to infinity. Now, if it is tends to infinity, this is as lambda tends to 0. If you put here, you know the here it is written 8 pi by lambda to the power 4. Now, here if we put lambda equal to 0, then what you will get? If lambda equal to 0, what is the value of U lambda energy density? If lambda equal to 0, U lambda equal to what? Written here already in the
infinity.
So, whereas experimental results show, so energy density, if we put the value of lambda equal to 0, I'm getting that U lambda tends to infinity. Whereas experimental results shows that as lambda tends to 0, U lambda tends to 0. This is the experimental result. But from here, what we are getting that if lambda tends to 0, U lambda becomes infinity. But experimentally, we are getting what? That is lambda tends to 0. If it is, then U lambda tends to 0. This implies that for a given quantity of radiant energy, all the energy is finally confined in the short wavelength region, that is the ultraviolet region. So this is the serious discrepancy between the theory and experiment. So experiment shows this one and the theory shows this one. So there is discrepancy between the theory and the experiment. And this is known as ultraviolet catastrophe or Jeans paradox. So remember this one, it is given that what is ultraviolet catastrophe. Write it in your copy. This is very, very important. If you get this question, you may get in semester or your class test, this type of question, what do you mean by ultraviolet catastrophe or Jeans paradox for short answer type. And this is this case that for theoretically we are getting lambda tends to 0, U lambda tends to infinity, but experimentally we are getting lambda tends to 0, but U lambda tends to 0. So this is discrepancy between this result and this result. So this is the ultraviolet catastrophe. This result is due to the limitation of well-being classical laws on the basis of which Rayleigh-Jeans law is derived. So this is the reason that due to the limitation of well-being classical laws on the basis of which Rayleigh-Jeans law is derived. So this is the Rayleigh-Jeans law. This is the Rayleigh-Jeans law. And from here we can explain it like this. Now from here we are getting the ultraviolet catastrophe or Jeans paradox. So remember these two conditions and this equation. And if you remember this equation U lambda D lambda, then just converting lambda to nu also you can write U nu D nu. Same equation, same expression, but in terms of frequency, when you will write U nu D nu, you will get in terms of frequency, energy density, and here in terms of wavelength, what is written in this page. So remember this one, this is very, very important. Now Wien's distribution law. What is this? U lambda D lambda equal to A by lambda to the power 5 e to the power minus A by lambda T D lambda. This is for small lambda T, for small value, and fails for high lambda T. Now Planck's formula you already know, U lambda D lambda equal to this, that is 8 pi HC by lambda to the power 5 d lambda by e to the power hc by lambda k bt minus 1. So this is the value. This is written in terms of lambda, Planck's law. Now I'm taking different cases. What is small lambda t? So this is here for small lambda t. So matches qualitatively for small lambda t value, but fails at high lambda t. So this is the case. So the first one I'm taking, that is the first case, that is small lambda t. Now AC by lambda KBT, it is very, very greater than 1. So I have taken what? The value of lambda t is small. So if any fraction, if here in the denominator, what is here? Lambda t is here. In the denominator portion, lambda t is here. So if lambda t is very, very, it is small. If lambda t is small, then the overall value will increase or decrease. AC by lambda KBT, overall value will increase or decrease for small value of lambda t. If denominator is minimum, then overall value of the fraction, what will it will be?
Increase.
Maximum, that will be very high value it has, okay. So AC by lambda KBT, it is very, very greater than 1, that I am taking. So when lambda t is small, then AC by lambda KBT, it is very, very greater than 1. So what I am taking, so it is very, very greater than 1. So u lambda d lambda. So u lambda d lambda, that is equal to 8 pi ac by lambda to the power 5 e to the power minus ac by lambda kbt d lambda. So u lambda d lambda, that is equal to 8 pi ac by lambda to the power 5. Hey, okay. So for this value, u lambda d lambda equal to 8 pi ac by lambda to the power 5 e to the power ac by lambda kbt d lambda. So for small lambda t, what is the value of u lambda d lambda? This is 8 pi hc by lambda to the power 5 e to the power minus hc by lambda kbt d lambda. So e to the power hc by lambda kbt, it is very, very greater than 1. This value is very, very greater than 1. So this term I am neglecting. So only remains this one, the first term, because this term minus 1. So this term is very, very high. It has very high value. This term has very, very high value. So we can neglect this one. And so what I will write? I will write e to the power. If I write in the numerator, then I will write it as e to the power minus hc by lambda kbt. That I have written. So u lambda d lambda equal to this. This is for small lambda t. So this has the value. Now, Wien's law of energy distribution in the spectrum of black body radiation, that we can write u lambda d lambda equal to 8 pi ac by lambda to the power 5 e to the power minus ac by lambda kbt d lambda. So this expression just I have derived. This is the Wien's law of energy distribution. So Wien's law can be explained, can explain the energy distribution in the shorter wavelength region alone and breaks down in longer wavelength region. So it may be given in MCQ. Remember this one. Wien's law can explain the energy distribution in the shorter wavelength region and breaks down in the longer wavelength region. So mark it in your copy. So this is the Wien's law of energy distribution. Energy distribution, this is very important. That is for small value of lambda t, it exists for a small value of lambda t. So it is, and for fails, it is fails for high value of lambda t. So for small value of lambda t, the value of u lambda d lambda, it is given. So this is the Wien's distribution law. So remember this one, this law. So different laws are there: Rayleigh-Jeans law, Wien's distribution law, Planck's radiation law, and these two laws, Wien's law of energy distribution and the Rayleigh-Jeans law, that is derived from which law? From which law we are deriving these two equations or these two laws? Tell me.
Planck's law.
Planck's law of radiation. Taking the approximation of the Planck's law of radiation, we have derived this law. And when, which one this, and this law is valid for a particular region. And Wien's law, it is valid for small value of lambda t. As it is valid for small value of lambda t, now taking the approximation, we have this equation. So remember this one. Now it is the graphically, it is the comparison of Wien's law and Rayleigh-Jeans law with the experimental curve of black body radiation. So energy density of radiation, it is plotted along the y-axis, and along x-axis lambda is plotted. So comparison of Winslow and Rayleigh-Jeans law with the experimental curve of black body radiation. Now see, this is the Rayleigh-Jeans law. This is the experimental curve. So middle one is the experimental curve, and this is the Wien's law. So all the laws are plotted in this graph. So this is the comparison. So this graph, this figure is very important. You have to draw it. Now next, Wien's displacement law, lambda mt equal to b, that is constant. Now u lambda, we were writing before this u lambda d lambda equal to something, this one. So I have d lambda, I have not written, I have only written u lambda value. So I have only written u lambda value, so this is the value. Now what I am taking, that just taking the derivative, del u lambda by del lambda, that is equal to zero. Now let some mathematical expressions are here. I am taking that c1 equal to hc by kb, that I am taking, and cx equal to c1 by lambda m t. Now if we can write it in this way, then this equation we can write it x minus 5 e to the power x plus 5 equal to 0. Now this is an transcendental equation which cannot be solved analytically. Only way to solve it, graphical method. The point of intersection of the two graphs, we will get y equal to x by 5 and y equal to 1 minus e to the power minus x gives the solution, which in turn turn out that is x, from which we can calculate x equal to 4.97. So if we put x equal to 4.97, so lambda mt, that is what, that value I have written, ac by this one, 4.97 into kb. So lambda mt, that is equal to what, if we put all the values here and we can calculate, that will, I will get some value, that is I have written that constant as b. So this is constant, so we can write that lambda mt equal to constant. So this is the Wien's displacement law. So remember this one. If you have problem in deriving this, don't go through this, only remember here, that is lambda mt, that is equal to constant. This is the Wien's displacement law. And from where we are getting this, we have the expression of u lambda. We are taking the derivative here, u lambda, del u lambda by del lambda equal to zero. Pore phone kora, ami class e achi. So this is the value of u lambda that I have written, and taking this del u lambda by del lambda, that I have taken zero. Then some mathematical calculations, and from this we have the value of x. Now we have the value of x, and we have given the value of x in that equation, and lambda equal to, finally just remember this one, lambda mt equal to constant. This is the Wien's displacement law. Now this is the spectrum of black body radiation. U lambda is plotted along y-axis, and here it is lambda along x-axis. Now for different temperatures, what will be the spectrum of the black body radiation? It is shown here. T1 is greater than T2, it is greater than T3, and here it is shown like this, T1, T2, T3. You can, this is the comparison. If the temperature varies, how u lambda will vary with lambda, that is shown in this graph. So in total black body radiation, so first thing, what is what I have discussed, origin of quantum theory, then black body, what is the definition, example, then the characteristics of black body radiation, Planck's hypothesis and radiation law, then the derivation of the Planck's law of radiation, derivation. So this is important. If you log for long answer type question, you may get question from here. The derivation of the Planck's law of radiation in terms of frequency and in terms of wavelength. This is in terms of wavelength and this is in terms of frequency. You can remember anyone and just convert it. If you remember in terms of frequency, then remember the relation between frequency and lambda, then you can write down u lambda d lambda. So this is very important, the derivation of the Planck's law of radiation. Then next, where I am coming, the last one, that is Planck's radiation law. And with this Planck's radiation law, Wien's law, Wien's displacement law, Rayleigh-Jeans law, that can be derived. And that I have discussed today. And with the second PPT, in the second PPT, different laws are derived with the approximation of the Planck's law. These all laws are derived with the approximation of Planck's law. The Rayleigh-Jeans law, this is the Rayleigh-Jeans law. Then this is the Rayleigh-Jeans law in terms of wavelength. Also, it can be written in terms of frequency. Then the ultraviolet catastrophe, that is very, very important. What do you mean by ultraviolet catastrophe or Jeans paradox? And why it arises? This question is important. Then Wien's law of energy distribution. This is the expression. And what is the significance of this law? Just written here. Wien's law of energy distribution. Now Wien's displacement law, what is the Wien's displacement law? That is lambda equal mt equal to constant. Lambda mt equal to constant, this is the Wien's displacement law. Now here two graphs are shown, two figures are shown, u lambda versus lambda, and comparison of different laws, Rayleigh-Jeans law, experimental curve, and this is the Wien's law. And here spectrum of blackbody radiation, this is shown, u lambda along y axis, lambda along the x axis. And for different temperature, how it will vary, this is shown. Now, this blackbody radiation is completed today. Now, next day, the note probably I have not given. The PPT, have I shared in your group? PPT? Have I shared the PPT of the blackbody radiation?
No, ma'am.
Okay. No,
ma'am. I will give the note, total blackbody radiation. You will read it very carefully. And whatever question I have mentioned, that it is very important. So write in your copy, mark it and prepare it. And that is the next after blackbody radiation. Tomorrow, what I will start? I will start Compton effect, particle property of wave. Compton effect. The Compton effect, what is Compton effect? Then different conservation theorem we have to take, we have to use here, and then we will derive finally. So calculation is very long calculation it has, so you can see here. So that I will derive, and this is I have derived the at last the expression of Compton wavelength. What is Compton effect? What is Compton wavelength? What is Compton shift? That is, these are the important questions. And this is the experimental setup for Compton effect. And here, different questions are shown also. So tomorrow that I will derive Compton effect. Compton effect is very, very important. You may get numerical problems also from Compton effect. So for theory, also for theory purpose, it is also very important. And mathematical problem, numerical problem, it is given frequently from Compton effect. So tomorrow I will discuss Compton effect. And today I will also share the note of the Compton effect and go through it if you get time. If you get time, then go through it. And when tomorrow I will discuss, that will help you. So the total notes of blackbody radiation and also for Compton effect I will share today. At this time, I'm very surprised with your class test marks. Same type of mistakes is from everyone. Same mistake. How it is possible? Probably you have consulted with your friends. Same type of mistakes. Repetition. Say you are doing some mathematical calculation you are doing. You have some problem given for you in exam, and you are calculating this. Then at the end, so everyone getting this, your answer is wrong. If it is right answer, then okay. Everyone is getting the answer, same answer, then okay. But the answer is wrong. But everyone are getting the wrong answer. Is it possible? Say anyone, is it possible? Say the answer is 10. A right answer is 10. Okay. So the right answer is 10. Is everyone get that? Then okay. Because this is the right answer. If you calculate in the proper way, you will get the answer. But everyone is getting 14. Is it possible? If it is wrong, you are calculating yourself, everyone individually calculating. So if you are doing wrong, you may one get 12, 13, 15, 20, 100, 200 like this. So it is possible that everyone are getting the same answer and this is the wrong answer. This proves that you have totally discussion with your friends, you have given the answers. And what you will get from this, I don't know. तुम लोग सोचे हो कि इससे तुम लोगों का बहुत फायदा होगा, पर फायदा होगा या घाटा होगा या बाद में पता चलेगा, तुम लोगों को ही पता चलेगा. That proves. Okay, so any question? I am not starting Compton effect today because it is not possible to start today. Only 10 minutes, 9 minutes time remaining, and this is totally different topic. So I am not starting this today. So if you have any question, then you can discuss. If you have any problem, you can discuss. Anyone? Anyone?
Ma'am, is chapter se koi math numerical aa sakta hai? Exam
numerical. Numerical तो नहीं, मतलब आने का चांसेस तो कम ही है. कहां से तुम बोलो ना, कहां से तुम्हें न्यूमेरिकल, कौन सा वैल्यू दिया जाए तो तुम कैलकुलेट करोगे, कौन सा वैल्यू बोलो. हम बोले राइट डाउन रेलेजेंस लॉ, ये हो सकता है, उसका कंडीशन क्या है रेलेजेंस लॉ का, ऐसा होता है, क्वेश्चन आता है. क्वींस डिस्प्लेसमेंट लॉ, व्हाट इज दिस, सो कैसे कब, प्लैंक्स लॉ से उसका डेरिवेशन, ये शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन आता है. Derive from Planck's law, derive Quinn's law from Planck's law, this type of question. And in all the region of the wavelength, it is not valid. Some conditions are given for different laws. What condition important hai? A condition diya jayega. In which condition it is valid? This type of problem. So this type of numerical, not numerical problem, probably will not get any numerical from here. So what you will calculate? Planck's law. Planck's law from here, energy density. That is not given actually. So remember the all the laws. Whatever I said, this is important. And I told though that in a Compton effect, you can get numerical problem. So you will get, in optics, you will get numerical problems. Different problems I have given. So have you prepared all the that problems that were given in the PPTs? Optics was not included in your class test. And the from for the next one, it will be. So whatever problem is there, I have given in the PPTs. So go through all the problems. Go through all the problems given in the PPTs. These are very important problems. And hum jab bhi class lete hain, jab bolte hain, ye important hai, isko mark karke rakho. To ye tum log mark karke rakhoge, to baad mein fayda hi hoga. Aisa nahi hai ki ek tab leke baith gaye aur mobile leke baith gaye aur class kiye, no pen and paper. ये This is not the correct procedure. You have to take one pen and paper, and whatever I am just discussing here, you have to do it yourself at the same time. This is the procedure. एक को तो 28 मिला था हम बोले थे, उसके बाद नेक्स्ट जो हाईएस्ट आया था आया है अभी तक मेरा कॉपी जो हम चेक किए उसके बाद 25 मिला एक को. वो है हो क्या वो किसको 25 मिला है
मैम?
व्हाट इज योर नेम
मैम? निशा.
निशा ओके. विष्णु को मिला है 28 एंड विष्णु तुम्हें ही तो मिला है 28.
Yes, ma'am.
हाँ उसके बाद मिला है निशा को 25. Next. तो ये the remaining copies I have not checked. तो एक के बाद एक कॉपी चेक कर रहे हैं Google Classroom से और रिटर्न कर रहे हैं तो तुम लोगों को तो पता ही चल रहा है. और सभी लोग I had वो मैथमेटिकल जो एक्सप्रेशन था ना जो डाइवर्जेंस निकालना था वहां पर सभी लोग I had, J had, K had लिख दियो. तुम लोग कॉपी अपना चेक कर सकते हो. वहां पर हम कार्ड दिए सभी को आई हैड जे हैड के हैड. तो बाहर में कॉपी जाएगा ना कि आप तुम लोगों का कौन सा टाइप का एग्जाम होगा मुझे तो पता नहीं है. तुम लोगों को भी पता नहीं है मुझे भी पता नहीं है. तो ऑफलाइन हुआ और कुछ भी हुआ क्या होगा पता नहीं है और ऑनलाइन भी हो सकता है. तो उधर ऐसे लिखोगे कहीं भी कोई भी देखे कि ऐसा आई हैड डॉट आई हैड होने के बाद वो आई हैड होता है आई हैड डॉट आई हैड होता है तो तुम लोगों को उसको टीचर को पता चल जाएगा ये स्टूडेंट को तो कुछ भी पता नहीं है ये तो वेक्टर ही नहीं जानता. ऐसे टोटल क्या होता है जानते हो? ओवरऑल इक्वेशन खराब हो जाता है कि स्टूडेंट को ना कुछ भी पता नहीं है ये इसको क्या कॉपी देखे. इसको पता ही नहीं है कि आई हैड डॉट आई हैड वन होता है जो लिख देता है आई हैड डॉट आई हैड होता है जेहट डॉट जेहट जेहट होता है. सभी लोग की हो एक भी नहीं ऐसा हुआ नहीं है. मैक्सिमम दो एक और दो नहीं की हो बाकी सब में ऐसा सेम है. तुम लोग अपना कॉपी देख कर समझ गए होगे क्या किए होगे. तो ये क्या होगा एग्जामिनर उसको जीरो देगा. हम मार्क्स दिए हैं पर वहां पर क्या होगा जीरो देगा. और सोचेगा ये स्टूडेंट को तो कुछ भी पता नहीं है कुछ भी लिखता रहता है. तुम्हारा जैसे फर्स्ट वाला ये एक प्रॉब्लम चेक करेगा टीचर तो उसका तुम्हारा इंप्रेशन टोटल खराब. और नेक्स्ट मार्क्स तुम्हारा जो भी जहां पर सही भी लिखे हो थोड़ा थोड़ा सही पूरा सही होगा तो फुल मार्क्स मिलेगा. वहां पर जो टीचर का कंसिडरेशन होता है उसको ऐसा लगेगा कि ये स्टूडेंट को तो कुछ भी पता नहीं है तभी पूरा कॉपी के ऊपर असर पड़ जाएगा. मानो इंटरव्यू में क्वेश्चन पूछा गया तुम इंटरव्यू देने गए कैंपस का कैंपसिंग का टाइम इंटरव्यू चल रहा है तुम्हें क्वेश्चन पूछा गया तुम ऐसा आंसर दे उसका तो जो पूछ रहा है उसको उसको लगा ही नहीं कि तुम्हें लिया जाए. मतलब इंटरव्यू तुम्हारा बाकी क्वेश्चन वो पूछेगा ही नहीं उसको एक एक क्वेश्चन में उसको पता चल जाएगा तुम्हारा अंदर क्या है. मतलब उस टाइम ही तुम आउट हो गए कैंपसिंग से. ऐसा होता है. ओवरऑल इंप्रेशन जो होता है वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. इतना सिली मिस्टेक करोगे ऐसा मिस्टेक करोगे जो 11, 12 का स्टूडेंट भी नहीं करेगा. ऐसे तुम लोग किए हो हर एक जगह पे. हम सोच रहे हैं ऐसा सेम मिस्टेक सभी को कैसे होता जाता है. तुम्हें एक ही तुम लोगों के पास मेरा सजेशन हम एक ही सजेशन देना चाहते हैं कि एक ही सजेशन है हम जो भी बोल रहे हैं उसको सुनो और अपना दिमाग मत चलाओ. तुम लोग अभी छोटे हो अपना दिमाग मत चलाओ जो भी टीचर बोल रहे उसको सुनो. इसमें तुम लोगों का ही फायदा है. टीचर बोल रहे हैं ये इंपॉर्टेंट है ये पढ़ना है मतलब पढ़ना है. अभी बाद में पता चलेगा जब बाद में पता चलेगा कि सुनने का फायदा क्या है. देखो अभी पीपल 38 दिखा रहा है शो कर रहा है. देखो दिस प्रूव्स दे आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड. पीपल 38 टोटल देखो 45 था एक एब्सेंट था. मतलब इन लोग ये लोग क्या है इन लोगों को सुनना नहीं है. मतलब टीचर जो बोल रहे हैं टीचर तो बक रहा है बकने दो उसमें क्या आता जाता है हम लोग तो कॉपी करके लिख देंगे. अल्टीमेटली फायदा क्या होगा फायदा होगा क्या इससे तुम लोगों का? कुछ भी फायदा नहीं होगा घाटा ही होगा. ऐसा मुफ्त का ज्ञान दे रहा है टीचर क्या करना है चलो साइन आउट कर दो लॉग आउट कर दो. सो क्या होगा ये बाद में पता चलेगा, क्योंकि ये बाहर जो है कंपटीशन बहुत ज्यादा है. तुम लोग समझोगे नहीं कुछ चीज को, सिर्फ फिजिक्स का नहीं है बात, फिजिक्स छोड़ दो, तुम लोग का आईटी का जो पेपर है, तुम लोग तो आईटी में हो, इंजीनियरिंग डिग्री आईटी में है, ये हैबिट बना रहा ना तो तुम लोग अपना कोर सब्जेक्ट में भी करोगे ऐसा. ये एक हैबिट है, क्लास ठीक से नहीं करना, एक दिन आना ठीक से, जो काम दिया जाए वो ठीक से नहीं करना, पंक्चुअलिटी नहीं है, ये सब ग्रो करो अपने अंदर. पंक्चुअल बनो, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, दैट यू हैव टू बी पंक्चुअल. ठीक है, ओके एवरीवन, कोई कुछ नहीं बोल रहा है, हम इतना बक रहे हैं तुम लोगों के लिए. हाँ शुभम कुमार,
यस मैम, यस
मैम, कुछ समझ में आया?
हाँ यस मैम, हाँ मैम.
तो क्या समझे?
मैम फॉलो करना टीचर्स का, मैम टीचर्स को फॉलो करना है, मैम टीचर्स का बात
करो, टीचर्स को फॉलो करो. और जानते हो इस बार एग्जाम में स्टूडेंट्स लोग, बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स लोग किया है, गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम हम दिए है और डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ ई जीरो पुट कर दिया है. वो था क्या तुम लोग के सिलेबस में? मतलब हम तो बोले नहीं थे कि वो पढ़ो, मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन में वो है, मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन हम बोले थे तुम्हारा मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन में सिलेबस में है, वो लिख दियो. और एक स्टूडेंट ने मुझे बोला कि सीनियर ने बोला, हाँ सीनियर ने बोल सकता है क्योंकि ये तब उन लोगों का सिलेबस में था, अभी तुम लोग का सिलेबस में नहीं है. गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम, गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम दिया गया था, तुम लोग क्या किए उसको डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ ई जीरो कर दिए और इतना बड़ा प्रूफ भी किए, कितना कष्ट हुआ तुम लोगों का, वो प्रूफ भी किए, डिराइव किए, उसके बाद मिला जीरो, बड़ा सा जीरो मिला है विद क्रॉस मार्क्स. जो लोग ये किया उन लोगों को पता है. ठीक है, तो ठीक है, टाइम इज ओवर, आई एम नॉट कंटिन्यूइंग द क्लास आफ्टर दिस, सो सेंडिंग द पीपीटीज, जस्ट गो थ्रू इट एंड रीड इट. ओके.